This is Howard Benson, and I'm here to show you around my plugin that's called Howard Benson Vocals, and it's by Joey Sturgis Tones. The plugin is basically an amalgamation of all the effects, settings, and everything I would use when I'm working in a session. And it's really versatile. It's the kind of thing I would use to do everything. Now, I used to use like 5 or 6 different plugins. Now I only need one plugin. That's kind of why I wanted to create it. It's easier for me to work like this, and for doing all your vocals, you pretty much don't need anything else besides this. You can use it in different ways. You can use it as a straight channel strip. You can use it as a channel strip with effects. You can use it as just an effects return. So I'll demonstrate all three of those. So the artist I'm working on right now is an artist named Diamante. She's a rock singer, and we're working on a new song of hers that's called Obvious. And right now we're about, I guess we would say, in the third inning of this song. We got the vocals done, but we have some drums that we have to do and some bass. So it's not a mixed record or anything like that, but the vocals have been tuned and comped and everything. So normally when I do a session, I have to set up compressors, EQs, effects in different orders for the vocals to sound the way I want them. I'm kind of known for vocals, so this was a very important plugin for me to make to simulate what I normally do in a session, in a professional session, in a setting where you have a singer singing, you have a mix down, all kinds of different situations. So I'm gonna play the session without the plugin so you can hear the difference. As soon as I put the plugin on, and this is my basic vocal setting, you'll hear exactly what happens. This is without it.
In my stomach, but I don't want to go home.
And I'll solo it.
Naked in your hotel room, I'm so cold lying next to you. Got another girl inside your phone. Ache in my stomach, but I don't want to go home.
So that's a very well recorded flat vocal. That's how I like to record vocals. I like to record them with no EQ, through a Neve, through a TubeTech compressor, and basically straight into the computer. So it's not a lot of compression, no futzing around. That way I can manipulate the vocal as much as I want. I'm not working with a super compressed vocal, a super EQ'd vocal. It's a very flat vocal with all the frequencies. So when I put the compressor on, when I put the plugin on rather, here's what you hear.
Naked in your hotel room, I'm so cold lying next to you. Got another girl inside your phone. Ache in my stomach, but I don't want to go home.
So you see what happens immediately. It pulls the vocal straight up almost to your face. So essentially what I'm doing on this particular vocal, and pretty much every vocal I do, is I have a lot of compression going. I've got the compressor pretty much turned all the way up, the auto makeup all the way up. I'm not using a lot of tube or thin grit because I don't want it on this particular vocal. But what I have done is I've sent the EQ pre the compressor. So essentially what's happening is, as opposed to compressing and then EQing, which means that if you EQ, you're gonna really hear it. I like to put the EQ before the compressor so I can crank up. For example, I'm adding 3.6 dB, 3.6 dB, one's at 2,500. And once it's 2100, that's a lot of EQ, but because it's before the compressor, it actually pushes that EQ down and blends it into the vocal more, so you have like a sheen across the vocal. It's a pretty good trick to know. So you can also add an EQ after that if you want, but I find that adding the EQ before, it gives me way more latitude in the kind of EQ I can use. So if you listen to it here.
Naked in your hotel room, I'm so cold lying next to you. Got another girl inside your phone, ache in my stomach.
Very, very clear, super clear vocal in the mix. So that's a pretty basic vocal sound for me. When you get into choruses, I don't change the vocal sound at all. I'll just add a double. Like for example, here's the chorus vocal.
Too much, and it's obvious.
You see how well the plugin is handling that vocal? It's bringing it down, it's blending it in. Here it is blended into the mix.
Obvious that I care way too much.
But because I like to double vocals, here I will do in my production part of it, I'll have a doubled vocal going along with the lead vocal. So that's what this will sound like.
Obvious that I care. care way too much, and it's obvious that I'm nowhere good enough, and it's obvious.
Now, most people, including me, won't have the double as loud, but you can see how it's sort of glued together. I'll bring it down to sort of how I would normally do it. So here's the vocal without any effects.
Naked in your hotel room, I'm so cold lying next to you. Got another girl inside your phone, ache in my stomach, but I don't want to go home.
I don't use that much reverb, but when I use it, I usually call out to my engineers, I need some space. All I want to do is sync the vocal back a little bit. So in this case, you have a very useful, great sounding reverb to get your vocal to have some space. So that's what we made this to be, an all-purpose setting.
Naked in your hotel,
that's a smaller
room.
Sound room,
I'm
bigger
so
sounding room,
lying next to you.
And you have an amount
got
knob.
Another girl inside your phone, ache in my stomach.
Pretty self-explanatory if you've ever used reverbs before, pretty easy to use. To me, the echo part is what I use on pretty much every record. Echo is what we're calling delay here. So when I turn it on, you hear what I'm saying.
Naked in your hotel room, I'm so cold like that.
That's in stereo. That's a ping pong delay. This is the setting I would use on pretty much every record. Ping pong delay, and this button here, which is called lo-fi. I personally like how a delay sounds when it's EQ'd, when the top end and bottom end's EQ'd out. Because a lot of times, a lot of artists will say to me, hey man, you put so much delay on my vocal. Well, it does sound good with delay because it kind of sinks it back into the mix. It gives it some width that you hear in an ad coming out of both channels. It's all good. But sometimes they just don't want to hear it. So the lo-fi button is sort of made to kind of make it be invisible. So like, for example, if I'm playing it like this.
Naked in your hotel room, I'm so cold.
This is a delay.
Next to you. Got another girl inside your phone.
You can hear it. But if I put the lo-fi on.
I'm so cold lying next
it's there,
to you.
But you don't hear it. But it's doing the job. And the main thing is it doing the job. You don't necessarily have to hear delay. You just want to have it do what it's supposed to do, which again is to sync the vocal into the mix and give it some left and right, some schmutz, as we say. When you listen to the width setting, it basically takes a mono signal, which most vocals are, and turns it into and spreads it out like that. So in solo, you'll hear what I'm talking about.
Naked in your hotel room, I'm so cold lying next to you. Got another girl inside your phone, ache in my stomach, but I don't want to.
So I use this very judiciously. I will go like this.
Naked in your hotel room, I'm so cold lying next to you.
Just makes it go from here to there. And so it takes up more space. So a lot of times what I'll do is I'll record a lot of the same singer singing over and over and over. I won't even tune it. I'll just blend it in, and that makes the choruses sound bigger. Once you start tuning it, it actually makes it worse. You want to kind of leave it untuned. In this case, that's what this thing does, the multiplier. It's based off of a part of a modular synth called the sample and hold module. What sample and hold does is it picks off of white noise. It samples and it picks off random numbers and white noise. So you're sending random numbers to this multiplier module. And what that does is it varies the pitch and timing randomly. So when you blend in, and I can talk about it forever, but I'll show you exactly what it does. So here's a vocal.
Naked in your hotel room, I'm so cold like.
The offset is basically greater pitch change, greater delay change. The amount would be sort of like the mix of it, if you wanted to say it in a more understandable term. So here's the offset.
Naked in your hotel room, I'm so cold lying next to you. Got another girl inside your phone, ache in my stomach, but I don't want to go home. Some nights I feel invisible to you.
So
like
you want to be really careful with this because you want to use it gently, and this is what it would do.
Care way too much, and it's obvious that I'm nowhere good enough. you.
So that's, you have to be super easy on these two parts, because what you don't want to do is you don't want to make it so it sounds pitchy. You just want to make it so you're making your vocals bigger. That's why on the multiplier, I would use it very, very gently. So to me, that sounds like four or five vocals singing at once, but it's only one. So this is how I use the plugin. I'm really, really interested to see how you guys use the plugin, because one thing I've realized about every plugin that I've ever been involved with is that the users actually come up with ways that I would never have thought of in a million years to use it. And this is an extremely versatile plugin that I can see by the fact that we have ways of rearranging the modules here and different ways of using it, that I could see how you guys would come up with something that I might go, oh my God, that's unbelievable. I never thought of that. So I really hope that that happens. So for any more information about the plugin, go to joeysturgistones.com.